Hello everyone, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. Yes. What are we discussing in the previous class?
Sir, the types of nephrons we finished.
We finished with types of nephron. Okay. Just a minute. We are going to discuss types of nephron. We have discussed that, or we are about to discuss that?
So we finished discussing.
Yes. Let's see. Types of nephron we have done. Okay. Have we done this point? A very important point. Glomerulus Bowman's capsule, PCT and DCT is situated in the cortex. Henle's loop is situated in the collecting duct. Henle's loop and collecting duct is situated in the medulla part. Yes or no? I think we are done with that.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Suresh, are you there now? Yes. Let's see, everyone. The next thing is mechanism of urine formation. What? Mechanism of urine formation. Yes or no? Am I audible clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, let's see. First is glomerular filtration. Second is tubular reabsorption. And third is tubular secretion. Let's see. Glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, and tubular secretion. There are three. Agreed, everyone? Agreed, everyone? Let's see. Now, you people have two kinds of pressure that is there. One is hydrostatic pressure, another is colloid osmotic pressure. Hydrostatic pressure is due to fluid, and colloid osmotic pressure is due to dissolved protein. Yes or no? Colloid osmotic pressure is due to dissolved protein. Yes or no? Agreed? Yes. See how that pressure is going to work. Like, see, this is a pipe, and if I will talk about hydrostatic pressure, if a pipe is going to burst or ruptured, what happens? The water moves outside, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? That means the hydrostatic pressure on this wall is towards outer side. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And on this wall, it will be towards, means from fluid towards wall. It is acting. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
And let's see, proteins are colloidal in nature. What? Proteins are colloidal in nature. Let's see what will happen in case of protein. In case of protein, what will happen? Protein will try to bring the fluid towards itself. Yes or no? Will try to bring the fluid towards itself. Agreed? Means protein having capacity of holding the fluid. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Protein having capacity of holding the fluid means if something is pulling the fluid on this direction, so colloid osmotic pressure will be there from the wall towards inside of fluid. Yes or no? This is the direction. This is the direction. Agree, everyone? Agreed? Agreed?
Yes,
now, yes, let's see. Now, let's see. I will talk about glomerular filtration. This is your glomerulus. This is your Bowman's capsule. See, this is the cross section of this membrane. And this is known as filtration membrane. This is known as filtration membrane. Agreed? Now let's see. What is there towards inside? Let's see. From this side, a deep blue color membrane is there, na?
Yes,
and
sir.
From this side, the black color membrane is going on. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
See, this blue color cell is deep blue color cell is representing this blue membrane of Bowman's capsule, sorry, glomerulus, and this black one is representing this membrane of Bowman's capsule. Yes or no? You see, this is the endothelium of glomerular blood vessels. Yes or no? Endothelium, that is the epithelial tissue. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Below that, its basement membrane is going to be there. Below this, its basement membrane is going to be there. Basement membrane of which layer? Every epithelial tissue having its own basement membrane.
Yes, sir.
The gray basement membrane is going to belong to these endothelial cells. Yes or no? Agreed? Do you people know this thing?
Yes, sir.
Just below the epithelium, basement membrane will be there, na? This gray one is going to belong to which layer? This deep blue. That is the endothelium of glomerular blood vessels. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? What is this gray one? What is this gray one?
Basement membrane of endothelium.
Yes. Now, what is this deep blue? This is the basement membrane of this layer. Yes or no? Because this side lumen is there. So it will be below this only. So these are known as podocytes. What? These are known as podocytes. They are having foot processes which is going to bind to the blood vessel. Yes or no? You see, modified squamous epithelial cells. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
Agreed, everyone? Let's see. They are the podocytes. What are they? Podocytes. So what is there? Endothelium of glomerulus. This side, endothelium of glomerulus. Then basement membrane of glomerulus, endothelium. Then basement membrane of podocytes, then podocytes. These layers are there. So actually endothelial cells, the basement membrane and podocytes are there across which filtration is going to take place. Yes or no? Across which filtration is going to take place. This side blood is there and here filtrate will be formed. Yes or no?
Yes.
Agreed, everyone? Now let's see. Let's see. There are a small pores present towards the endothelial layer. That is known as fenestra. What? Fenestra. And this is known as podocytes. What? This is known as slit pore. What? Which kind of pore? the slit pore. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
Agreed, everyone? This is known as the slit pore. Let's see, dear. What I want to tell you all, this is fenestra, this is slit pore, this is endothelial cells, this is podocytes. What is there in between? Basement membrane. These are the layers across which it is going to be filtered. Agreed? Only this area is magnified over here. Yes or no? Yes or no? Now, one thing. Even Bowman's capsule having two walls. One is parietal, that is the outer wall, and one is visceral, that is the inner wall. So which wall of Bowman's capsule is lined by podocytes? Is it parietal or visceral? Is it parietal or visceral? Which wall of Bowman's capsule is going to be lined by podocytes? Is it parietal or visceral? Which wall?
Visceral.
Visceral. Okay. So podocytes lines the visceral wall of Bowman's capsule. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You people can draw this one. After that, I will discuss later on. Done, dear. Have you understood this thing? The filtration membrane?
Yes, sir. Just a minute.
And the pressure? Yes. Copy it.
Done, sir.
Done, dear. Now let's see.
Just a minute.
No issues.
Done, sir.
Done, everyone. Let's see, dear. Now, what we are up to here, let's see. There are two kinds of pressure inside the Bowman's capsule and two kinds of pressure inside the glomerulus. Resultant of that pressure will be known as net filtration pressure or effective filtration pressure. Under that only the filtration is going to be done. Let's see. This is the hydrostatic pressure inside the glomerulus. What do you think? In which direction it should work? From the fluid towards the wall. In this direction, yes or no? Hydrostatic pressure?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? And colloid osmotic pressure over here. From the wall towards the fluid. Agreed? Now, this is BH. Hydrostatic pressure inside the Bowman's capsule. Let's see. Hydrostatic pressure from the fluid towards the wall in this direction. Yes or no? Hydrostatic pressure inside the Bowman's capsule. And this is the colloid osmotic pressure inside the Bowman's capsule. Means from the wall towards the fluid in this direction. Yes or no? In this direction. Agreed? Do you people agree with all these directions?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Tell me, dear. Everyone, do you people agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Now, important thing. Let's see what I want to tell you all. Over here, a very significant fact. This is known as ultrafiltration because filtration is done so finely that everything gets filtered except protein. Protein do not come over here. So for what reason colloid osmotic pressure is there? What is the reason behind colloid osmotic pressure? It is due to dissolved proteins. Agreed? It is due to dissolved proteins. Agreed?
Yes,
it is due to dissolved protein. Agreed? Colloid osmotic pressure. It is due to dissolved protein. No issues? Now, none of the protein is coming over here. So this should be zero, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now I am going to calculate net filtration pressure. It should be GH plus BCOP and BH plus GCOP. Difference of that. Yes or no? GH is 60 mm of Hg, BCOP will be 0. BH is 18 mm of Hg and GCOP is 32 mm of Hg. Will come out to be 10 mm of Hg. Yes or no? So what is the net filtration pressure over here? 10 mm of Hg. Agreed? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Read.
Yes, sir.
Let's see over here. Now, see this and try to interpret it. What is the meaning of this thing? Can you interpret anything out of it? Take a minute. Please try to think. Renal filtration coefficient. It is a function of number of nephron. Till your number of nephron is not changing, it will not change. It is saying for 1 mm of Hg pressure difference, 12.5 ml of filtrate will be formed per minute. For 1 mm of Hg, pressure difference, agreed? What should be there? In 1 minute, this is the volume of filtrate that is being formed. that is being formed. Agreed? No issues? So for 1 mm of Hg, this is the volume. So for 10 mm of Hg, what will be the volume? Agreed? Till your yes. kidney is normal, renal filtration coefficient or KF will not change. And it is 12.5 ml per mm of Hg per minute. What is the meaning of this? For 1 mm of Hg pressure difference, what is the volume of filtrate that is formed per minute? 12.5. So for 10 mm of Hg pressure difference, it should be multiplied by 10. 125 ml per minute, that is 180 liters per day. This is known as glomerular filtration rate. Agreed, everyone? It is the volume of filtrate formed by both the kidneys per minute. It is the volume of filtrate formed by both the kidneys per minute. That is the definition of GFR. That is the definition of GFR. You people agree with this calculation, dear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You can write down now. Everyone, GFR is a very important definition. GFR is a very important definition. Please see to it. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Done? Now, you sir, people can...
Just yes. a minute.
Yes. You people can solve this question also. You can solve this question also. It is slightly... different from what we have calculated, so I will let you know the other aspect also after seeing this. Done?
Yes.
Everyone? Let's see here. What is the reason behind this? Try to think. And the next question. Thank you. this question is very logical question. Proteinuria is appearance of protein in urine. Appearance of protein in urine. Agreed? Okay, you have to consider that level of protein in blood is constant. Means colloid osmotic pressure of glomerulus is constant. It is only changing inside the Bowman's capsule. You all can see this question and try to solve with this diagram only. We will discuss both of them.
So in the second question, will GFR increase?
Yes, of course it will increase, because let's see what happens. It was zero earlier, but now it will have some value. So here it zero will not be there. Some value will be added. So this will increase. Yes or no? Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes.
Everyone? And GH having a range of 60 to 75 mm of Hg. Considering this length, you should see what should be the likely answer in this case. It should be 20 mm of Hg, because practically 75 mm of Hg is not possible. That never happens, but it is given in others, and it is given in other mammals also.
So,
yes.
So what's the range of GH?
60 to 75 mm of Hg. Here I have taken 60 only, but it can go till this.
Sir, also in the second question, why won't GFR decrease? Filtration rate will decrease, right?
If here protein will come, some colloid osmotic pressure will be there in over here, na?
So
this will add up over here. And that will increase what? Multiply with this. You will get an increased GFR. Everyone. You will get increased GFR. Everyone. Tell me, dear. Say yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Glomerular filtration rate is done now. One thing you people should be knowing. Let's see, dear. Renal blood flow is 1100 to 1200 ml per minute. It is for both the kidneys. So what is the likely renal plasma flow? What is the likely value of renal plasma flow? What is the percentage of plasma in blood? What is the percentage of plasma in blood? Tell me, what is the percentage of plasma in blood? It is 55%. What?
55.
It is 55%. So please take out 55% of this. Roughly it is 650. It is an average value. Hai na? 650 ml per minute. Yes or no? Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
And what do you know? What do you think? Plasma is filtered or blood is filtered? It is plasma that is filtered. Yes or no? Blood cells nothing to do have with, you can say nothing to do with filtration. Agreed? Plasma is filtered means this much volume of plasma is coming to kidney. Out of that, this much is getting formed at filtrate. This much is getting formed in kidney, coming to the kidney. Out of that, this much is getting formed as filtrate. So what is the fraction of plasma that is formed as filtrate? 1/5. Almost. Means 650 ml is coming. Out of that, what is the volume that is formed as filtrate? 125 ml. Yes or no? What is GFR? 125 ml na? Per minute. Say yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the fraction of plasma that is filtered as filtered over here? Tell me that. It is around 20%. No issues? So, if somebody will give you, the blood volume, you can calculate the filtration fraction. Yes or no?
Yes.
You will calculate the plasma flow by taking 55% of that, and then 20% of that will be filtration fraction. Yes or no? Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Calculate the renal fraction. Please calculate. You people have understood it or not?
Yes. So in these cases, do we assume GFR to be 125, or will it be given in the question?
See, you just take out this 20%, around 20%. Okay. Blood volume is given. It's 55% will be plasma, and 20% of plasma will be filtration fraction. Yes or no? Or 1/5?
So will it be constant like that?
No, not always. Not always. It can fluctuate a bit. Almost it is constant.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes.
Sir, is it 220 ml?
Please calculate. Let others also calculate. It will be 20% of 1100 ml, I think.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So in these questions, so do we assume filtration fraction to be constant or GFR
yes.
to be constant?
See, filtration fraction is also almost 20%. If question will be asked like this, na, you have to assume that as a 20% only. Agreed?
Yes.
Either all the data should be given. Otherwise, because if you see, if this will increase, na, GFR can also increase. Yes or no?
Yes. Done, sir.
Everyone, do you people have any doubt in renal blood flow, renal plasma flow, and filtration fraction?
No, sir.
No, let's see. See over here, dear. Selective tubular secretion, reabsorption, and secretion, both are there. So first, what is the meaning of reabsorption? See, anything that is moving through this nephron will be eventually excreted out as urine. Yes or no? Means if something will remain inside the lumen of the nephron, it will be excreted out of the body. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no? Please pay attention to my point. I am saying if something is going to remain inside the lumen of the nephron, what it is going to do? It will excrete that substance out of the body. What if your body is going to require that substance? What should happen? It should be removed from the lumen and will be put inside the renal interstitium, where peritubular capillaries and vasa recta is there that will take it away. Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Please say yes or no quickly.
Yes.
I am saying over here that if something is going to remain inside the lumen, what should happen?
So it should be excreted out.
Yes. But if that is useful for your body, then body has to take it out from the lumen and put it inside the renal interstitium, so that what should happen? It should be taken, it will be taken away by vasa recta and you can say peritubular capillaries that is there. I have told you in earlier diagram, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Those are blood vessels. So movement of any substance from lumen to renal interstitium is known as reabsorption. Yes or no? And movement of any substance from interstitium into the lumen is known as what? Secretion. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Secretion. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, secretion is movement from renal interstitium to the lumen of nephron, and reabsorption is movement from the lumen to renal interstitium. Do you people agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Now, you see, the secretion and reabsorption is going to be selective. What? It is going to happen with particular substance. But what about filtration? Everything is getting filtered, no?
Yes.
So it is non-selective. Everything is coming. Agreed, dear? So glomerular filtration is selective or non-selective?
Sir, non-selective.
Non-selective. And glomerular filtration is non-selective. And what about tubular secretion and reabsorption?
So selective.
They are happening with certain substance only. You see, in PCT and DCT, what are common? NaCl, bicarbonate, and H2O. They are common. They are reabsorbed in PCT as well as DCT. Agreed? Now, what is additional in PCT? It is 70% of the nutrient. What? 70% of the nutrient. 100% of the nutrient. 70% is something else I'm going to tell you. Means if amino acid is there, glucose is there, that will be absorbed 100% in? 100% in? PCT only. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
If nutrient is there, 100% will be absorbed inside the PCT only. Agreed? So if somebody will ask you what is the percentage of absorption of glucose inside DCT, what will you say?
100%.
DCT, I have asked. Will it be 0%?
No, sir.
Will it be 0% inside DCT because 100% is absorbed in?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
No issues? So, what is the percentage of absorption of a nutrient inside PCT?
100%.
100%. Yes or no? Now, from the PCT, this is secretion. H plus and NH3 is secreted. And here K plus and H plus is secreted. That is conditional. If it is more, then only it will be secreted. If it is not in that much quantity, it will not be secreted. Yes or no? From the descending limb, H2O will be reabsorbed. From the ascending limb, NaCl will be reabsorbed. From the collecting duct, you see urea is reabsorbed and then again secreted inside the ascending limb of Henle's loop. And here, water is reabsorbed. I have told you the reason, because of presence of aquaporins on collecting duct. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is there. You all can note it down. First, understand the meaning of secretion and absorption. Then you will get to know the things. You people are getting things, na? Any doubt in that?
No,
and my
sir,
voice is clear. Voice is clear, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes. I have changed the setup. You can see setup that is there. That is why I'm asking.
Excuse me, sir. What have you written in the diagram next to H plus?
Where? This one?
Oh, yes, sir.
Interstitium. This area is interstitium. And this is interstitium. This is lumen.
Yes, sir.
Done, everyone?
So just a minute.
Okay. Done.
Yes, sir.
Now, one important concept is of threshold, renal threshold. Now you see, please try to understand my point. One important thing I am saying. For say, glucose that is coming over here is, let's see, it is 100 gram. All will be reabsorbed. 120 gram, all will be reabsorbed. 130 gram, all will be reabsorbed. But there will be some value after at which the absorption capacity of PCT will be exceeded by the concentration like 180 gram. Now, it cannot absorb more than 180 gram, yes or no? Or say, PCT cannot reabsorb more than 180 gram. What will happen in that case? That glucose will appear in?
Urine.
So, is that is threshold. Is that a lower limit or upper limit?
So upper limit.
Is that a lower limit or upper limit, everyone?
Upper limit.
So it is the maximum concentration of any substance in plasma till which it do not appear in the urine. That is known as renal threshold. Yes or no? At times when renal threshold for glucose is low, in that case, glucose comes in urine at lower concentration also. So can I say that glycosuria is there always? That, tell me, glycosuria is there always? Diabetes mellitus is there?
No, sir.
Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed?
Yes.
No issues?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Now, low threshold substance, urea is there, uric acid is there. Non-threshold substance is uric acid. Now, try to understand my point. Your excretory matter should be low threshold substance or high threshold substance?
So low threshold.
Low threshold substance only. Non-threshold means it will come and will be excreted. No upper limit is required. Yes or no? Everyone? So can I say that glycosuria is there? Is it always diabetes mellitus? Is it always diabetes mellitus? It may be low renal threshold also. It may be low renal threshold also. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Done? Everyone? In case of low renal threshold also, glucose will come in urine. It is not necessarily diabetes mellitus always. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So, write down a statement. Glycosuria always represents diabetes mellitus. That statement will be right or wrong?
Wrong, sir.
Wrong. Now, on DCT, aldosterone is going to work. It will perform reabsorption of Na plus and secretion of K plus. It will perform reabsorption of Na plus and you can say secretion of K plus. Means, if that is happening, you will ask me that, sir, what is the volume, you can say concentration of Na plus that is reabsorbed, that concentration of K plus is secreted, then also water is reabsorbed. Why? You can ask me, no? If you will apply the concept of water potential over here. Can you ask me that question?
Yes, sir.
I have told you earlier, Na plus having higher hydration energy, it will attract more water molecule with it, with respect to K plus. Agreed? So K plus movement do not affect much the water movement, but Na plus too. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, changes in filtrate during movement through nephron.
Sir, could you scroll up? We can copy.
Yes, yes. Need not to copy this one. This I have pasted for some reference purpose.
Yes.
Done?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the changes in filtrate that is made while moving through the nephron? Agreed? Tell me, dear. I am saying over here, changes infiltrate during movement through nephron. See, when I have written in Hindi a bit, do you people understand a bit?
Yes, sir.
When water will move, it will cause change in volume as well as concentration. And when electrolyte will move, it will change the concentration only. Because electrolyte do not have that volume that it is going to affect the volume.
Yes.
Total volume of electrolyte is negligible. So let's see. Changes in filtrate during movement through nephron. Let's see, dear. This is Bowman's capsule. What happens? I have told you everything that is there in the plasma that comes over here. That means it is isoosmolar with plasma. In Bowman's capsule, almost similar to plasma. Yes or no? Apart from proteins. Yes or no?
Sir, it is almost similar to plasma. Yes, sir. It is almost similar after absorption or before absorption, sir.
See, this in Bowman's capsule, nothing had happened. Only filtrate is formed. Now, onwards, absorption and secretion will start.
Oh, yes, sir. Got it.
What happens in PCT? Try to understand my point. You have 1 liter of water and 100 grams of salt. Now you have 1,000 liter of water. Sorry, I should write ml. I have told 1 liter, no. Then 100 gram of salt is there. Now you have 100 ml of water. You have 10 gram of salt that is there. Yes or no? Agreed?
Yes. Sir.
Agreed, dear? Yes. Let's see. What I want to tell you over here is if you will take 100 ml of water and 100 gram of salt and 1000 ml of water and 100 gram of salt and 100 ml of water and 10 gram of salt. What is the concentration difference between them? I'm asking for concentration difference.
It's the same concentration.
Similar thing happens with PCT. See, electrolyte is absorbed actively. Yes or no? And in the same proportion, water is also absorbed. So if electrolyte is getting absorbed and water is moving passively in the same proportion, will the concentration change over here?
No, sir.
So concentration in PCT will be similar to plasma only, but volume will decrease because water is moving out. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And that also 70-80% volume decrease will be there. Now, what will be the change in descending limb of Henle's loop? Is there going to be there? In descending limb, water is moving out. If water is moving out, in that case, volume will decrease and concentration will increase. Agreed, dear?
Yes.
Everyone, what is the changes in ascending limb? See, electrolyte is moving out. What is moving out? Electrolyte is moving out. In that case, what will happen? Volume will be constant, concentration will decrease because I have told movement of electrolyte is not going to affect the volume. Yes or no? Movement of electrolyte will not affect the volume. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Agreed. So changes in, please observe again. You have to write it down also. Apply your logic, write carefully. Done, everyone?
So, could you scroll down?
Yes. See, in PCT, in descending limb and in ascending limb, you just apply your logic, and if you have any issue, you can ask me. Now, changes in proximal DCT. What is the change that is going to happen in proximal DCT? It is volume, concentration. Let's see what happens in proximal DCT, this part of DCT. NaCl is absorbed by the action of aldosterone. Yes or no? It is known as conditional reabsorption. What? When water scarcity condition will be there, no? In that case, aldosterone will be released and then it will be absorbed. Yes or no? So NaCl will be absorbed over here. So what will happen? If electrolyte is moving out in that case, volume will remain constant and concentration will decrease. And distal DCT, what is happening? Water is moving out. So volume is decreasing, concentration is increasing. Overall, volume will decrease, concentration will remain the same through in the DCT. Yes or no? First concentration is decreasing, then increasing, means it is similar to PCT only. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
In collecting duct, water is moving out. I have told you people, aquaporins were there, and that is under, aquaporins are under
the control of antidiuretic hormone.
Yes. So water is moving out, so volume is decreasing, concentration is increasing. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Two questions are there. You can find out the solutions.
So could you scroll up to the proximal distal DCT?
Done, everyone? You yes. Can solve these two questions. solve these two questions. Why concentration of urine is 4 times than that of filtrate? Do you people have the answer of this thing? And the second question. Are we done?
Yes.
See you. This question, do you people have answer?
So there's reabsorption taking place in many places, so it's more concentrated.
See, here it is 300 milliosmol per liter. Here it is 600 milliosmol per liter. Here it is 900 milliosmol per liter. And here it is 1200 milliosmol per liter. So you see 300, 1200. Urine is filtrate is forming over here and urine is passing from here. So it will be
4 times, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Filtrate is getting formed inside the cortex. So concentration inside the cortex is what? Concentration inside cortex is what?
300.
So one important thing is counter current mechanism of concentration the urine. Counter current mechanism of concentrating the urine. Let's see. This is known as Henle's loop. This is known as Wasserrichter. Henle's loop and Wasserrichter. Counter current multiplier and counter current exchanger. Agreed? Counter current multiplier and counter current exchanger. Let's see over here. What happens? You have to follow a funda, that is concentration inside is equals to concentration outside. Concentration inside is equals to concentration outside. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Concentration inside is equals to concentration outside. Let's see what is the significance of this thing. Concentration inside is equals to concentration outside. Let's see over here, dear. What I want to tell you all here, concentration outside is 300 milliosmol per liter. So it should be 300 milliosmol per liter over here. Here 600, here 600, here 900, here 900, here 1200, here 1200. Means 300, 600, 900, 1200. Concentration is increasing as we move down, move down along the descending limb of Henle's loop. Is it increasing or decreasing?
So increasing.
Is it increasing or decreasing?
Increasing.
Tell me. It is increasing. So how many methods that do you, you can say, do you people know to increase the concentration? How many methods that are there? If you have to increase the concentration of a solution, how many methods do you people have? Either add the solute or remove the solvent. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So what is feasible in descending limb of Henle's loop? What is feasible over here?
Sir, remove solvent.
Remove solvent. Because it is only permeable for water, not for electrolyte. So you see, water is moving out from the lumen into the interstitium. Agreed? From the lumen into the interstitium. Now, water is moving up. 1200, 900, 600 and 300. 1200, 900, 600 and 300 milliosmol per liter. Is the concentration increasing or decreasing?
Increasing.
Is the concentration, is it increasing or decreasing?
Sir, decreasing.
Decreasing. How many methods that you people know to decrease the concentration here?
Sir, remove the solute. Remove the solute or add the solvent?
What is feasible in ascending limb of endless loop?
So remove the solute.
Remove the solute. I am removing it in the interstitium. In the interstitium. Agreed? In the interstitium. Agreed? No issues? Yes, everyone? Everyone? Let's see, dear. You will see that along the ascending limb of endless loop, the descending of limb of vasa recta is flowing. Yes or no? Yes or no? Along with that only. Alongside with, you can say alongside ascending limb, descending limb of vasa recta is flowing. And vasa recta is a capillary, na?
Yes, sir.
So it is permeable for electrolyte as well as water. 300, 600, 900, 1200. The fluid is moving out. See, one thing I'm going to define over here, that hydrostatic pressure inside the vasa recta is already low, means water is less. So I have to increase the concentration. I can take both the methods. I will add the solute over here and will remove a little bit of water, not much, because already hydrostatic pressure inside the vasa recta is what? Low. 300, 600, 900, 1200. Concentration is increasing or decreasing?
So increasing.
Increasing. Concentration is increasing. And how many methods that you people know for increasing the concentration?
You add the solute and remove the solvent.
And vasa recta is a capillary, both can be done. Vasa recta is a capillary, both can be done. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Vasa recta is a capillary, both can be done. So I'm adding the solute over here and I'm removing the water from here. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you see, everyone will see the ascending limb of vasa recta, 1200, 900, 600, and 300. Concentration is increasing or decreasing? Concentration is increasing or decreasing?
Sir, decreasing.
Decreasing. Let's see. To decrease the concentration, how many methods can we apply? We can absorb the water as much as we can because already it is low. And we will remove, you can say remove a bit of solute also. So those water that is removed from the descending limb of endless loop, that will be transferred to ascending limb of vasa recta and this will go to blood flow. Yes or no? Is the water conserved over here? Is water conserved over here? Tell me. By this, water is conserved or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Yes. Now, this concentration gradient is maintained by NaCl and urea. Now you people can understand the role of urea transporter that I have written over here and over here. Little bit of urea that is recirculated in the interstitium is actually increasing the osmolarity of interstitium, which is helping in absorption of water. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Agreed here?
Yes, sir.
Now, mechanism is known as counter current mechanism because the direction of flow of fluid in both the limb of vasa recta and annulus loop is opposite. Is it opposite or not?
Yes, sir.
And it also runs in the gills of feces and nasal chamber of kangaroo rat. You people know what is kangaroo rat? That is there in the North American desert. Do not drink even a drop of water from the birth and till death. Only surviving on the water of you can say obtained by fat metabolism or fat oxidation. So it is essential for kangaroo rat to you can say absorb moisture from the expired air. For that, counter current mechanism is running over there also. Yes or no? In gills of feces also it is there. You people can write this thing, can see your NCRT a bit, because diagram inside in NCRT is a bit different from here. Sorry, but you people can easily compare and read. Done.
Just a minute.
Especially this line, question will be asked from here. Counter current mechanism, the meaning is important. Please see to it. Try to understand the things. If you are not getting anything, please ask. Agreed, dear? Please ask after that.
Yes.
So could you scroll down a bit?
Your exams are over, yes?
Oh, yes, sir.
You started solving the assignments?
Not yet, sir. The results were, I think, it got over this Monday, sir, so I'll start today.
Okay, no issues.
Yes.
Sir?
Yes.
Could you send like most of the assignments again? I was joined late on the WhatsApp group, so I don't have most of them.
No, so I will send.
Thank you, sir.
Properties of urine. The volume is 1 to 1.5 liters per day. Its pH is acidic. It is 4.5 to 6. A specific gravity is 1.010 to 1.025. Osmolarity I have told you. And color is straw color because of urochrome pigment. Yes or no? And what is the amount of urea that is excreted per day? It is 25 to 30 grams, 25 grams as per your NCRT. Yes or no? What is the amount of urea that is excreted per day? You can check with your NCRT. It is 25 grams per day. 25 to 30 grams per day. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Per day it is. Now, one important thing is there. That is how your kidney function is regulated. Yes.
Done, sir.
Done. So, we'll talk about regulation of kidney function. How your kidney function is being regulated. It is hypothalamus, it is JG apparatus, it is heart. Hypothalamus have osmoreceptors which perceive change in osmolarity. Or change in osmolarity is there in hypothalamus. Getting my point? In the blood, these osmoreceptors will pick that one. Yes or no? And you know that in your hypothalamus, third center is there. Yes or no? And it will increase the urge for drinking water. You will drink the water and osmolarity will become normal again. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It starts secreting ADH or vasopressin. You know, vasopressin or ADH is secreted from which part? Secreted from which part?
Hypothalamus.
ADH or vasopressin is secreted from which part? Tell me. Posterior lobe of pituitary. And it comes from hypothalamus only. So secretion of ADH or vasopressin is going to be started. That will open the aquaporins. That will lead to reabsorption of water and osmolarity again returns to normal. Yes or no? These two things are done by hypothalamus. When regulation means you can say changing things between physiological limit, yes or no? Changing yes, things between physiological limit.
Yes, sir.
So could you scroll down?
Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Diuresis, excessive loss of fluid from the body. And hence, which is the hormone which is preventing it is known as antidiuretic hormone. In absence of ADH, which disease is going to be there? Diabetes insipidus. If secretion of ADH is on the lower side, which disease is going to be there? Which disease is going to be there? It is diabetes insipidus. Let's see, if ADH is, you can say, secreted in lesser amount, what will happen here? Water will be absorbed more or less?
So less.
Water will be absorbed. If it will be absorbed less, in that case, what will happen?
So concentration
of fluids
increases.
I told ADH is increasing the water absorption or decreasing it?
Increasing.
Increasing. So if ADH will not be there, water absorption will increase or decrease?
Decrease.
If it will be decreased, in that case, it will be lost in urine. So frequent urination will be there. That condition is known as polyuria. If more water will be lost, in that case, more water have to be taken in. That is known as polydipsia, excessive thirst. In diabetes mellitus also, these two things will happen, but one is additional, that is polyphagia. Excess hunger will also be there. It is due to error in secretion or function of insulin. We will read about that in later classes. You can say in chemical control and coordination. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now.
Sir.
You can see. Yes.
Could you just show the diabetes mellitus? answer?
Yes or no? Let's see, dear. So hypothalamus is done. Now we have to read JG apparatus. You see, just imagine, this is your Bowman's capsule. This is afferent arteriole. This is efferent arteriole. You see, this is a DCT, agreed? Actually, the diagram of nephron that we used to teach you people, that is quite, you can say that is arranged in a nice way. But it is not like that. The complete nephron is intermingled with each other. In that way, DCT is touching the afferent arteriole also. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, where DCT is touching, the smooth muscle cell of the afferent arteriole will get modified to form JG cells. Agreed? Agreed. The smooth muscle fiber of afferent arteriole, getting my point, that get modified to form which cell?
JG cell,
which is going to secrete renin. Which is going to secrete renin? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Which is going to secrete renin? Agreed, dear? Now, the modified cells of DCT, this one, this is macula densa cells. What? Macula densa cells. Agreed, dear?
Yes.
Agreed, dear? Same. JG cells is going to secrete the renin, and macula densa cells is going to secrete. No, it is not going to secrete anything. It is acting like a osmoreceptor. If filtrate is moving, it will perceive the change in the, you can say, concentration of filtrate. Agreed? Osmoreceptor. So what is JG cells? It is the modified smooth muscle fiber of afferent arteriole. And what is macula densa cell? It is the modified cell of DCT. You can observe few cells in this area also. They are mesangial or lacis cells. They are supporting cells. Yes or no? They are supporting cells. Please draw the diagram. Done, everyone?
Just a minute.
Done, everyone?
So just a second.
Done, everyone. Let's see what is going to happen. Oh, actually, what this renin is going to do from liver, angiotensinogen is removed from liver. You can say it is secreted rather than removed. It is there in your blood. It is inactive. Now you see. BP is going to fall due to less fluid in the body. Water is not there. Agreed? Everyone? Water is not there. Because of that, what happened? BP has fallen. As BP will fall, it will start or it will stimulate the, you can say that JG cells to secrete renin from kidney. Agreed? Agreed? And angiotensinogen will be converted into angiotensin 1 by renin. Agreed? Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Yes. Now you all will see. Now you all will see that from the lung, ACE is secreted. What? ACE is secreted. Angiotensin 1 will be converted into angiotensin 2 by which? By ACE. Angiotensin converting enzyme. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
No issues? By angiotensin converting enzyme, ACE is converted into angiotensin 2. Let's see. Angiotensin 2 having three roles. One, it will stimulate the hypothalamus to stimulate the thirst center so that you are going to drink more water and you will recover your blood volume. Yes or no? And then it will act on adrenal cortex. And from adrenal cortex, it will make aldosterone to secrete. Agreed? And it will act on DCT. And what is the function of aldosterone that I have told you people? What is the function of aldosterone that I have told you people? Tell me. Reabsorption of Na plus and Cl minus, and along with that H2O will also be what?
Reabsorbed.
Yes. So by that also your blood volume is going to be recovered. Agreed here?
Yes, sir.
Now, third thing it will do on blood vessel and bring about vasoconstriction. What? Vasoconstriction. By that also, the blood pressure will increase. Agreed? So, yes. After action of angiotensin 2, all three will act and it will make blood pressure to increase. Agreed? It will make blood pressure to increase. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
No issues? And if blood pressure will be increased, it should not, you can say, increase beyond a limit. Otherwise, that will also going to cause some problem. Yes or no? Once blood pressure will start increasing above the normal level, heart will secrete ANF, atrial natriuretic factor, which is going to switch off the secretion of renin. Yes or no? Which is going to switch off the secretion of renin. So atrial natriuretic factor is known as check mechanism of RAS. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Renin, angiotensin, aldosterone 6, you can say system. This is the role of renin over here. See, a spelling of renin over here and in GIT, both are different here. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You can see over here. Done, everyone?
Just a minute, sir.
Are we done?
So just a minute. So could you scroll up to the ANF part? Done, sir.
Yes. We will be discussing the myogenic autoregulation after the break. Yes or no? We will be meeting you people after 10 minutes. Break is there. Yes, okay, 15 minutes, no issues.
Yes, sir.
Yes, everyone, I'm back. Let's see. You all are there? You all are there? And am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Let's see. What happens if there is abrupt increase in BP? If there is abrupt increase in BP, BP will increase, you can say, suddenly what will happen that can cause damage to the kidney. Agreed? You must be knowing this is one of the complications of increase in blood pressure, damage to the renal blood vessel or damage to the kidney. So what happens if this will happen? In that case, as blood will rush in that case, what will happen? Pressure will increase inside the vessel or not? Pressure will increase or not?
Yes, sir.
In that case, the blood vessel will be stretched. Yes or no? Blood vessel will be stretched. Yes or no?
Yes.
Blood vessel will be stretched. In that case, if it will be stretched from the intercellular space, it means you can say between the, you can say space present between the cells, calcium ion will rush in inside the myogenic layer of this. Yes or no?
Yes.
Blood vessel do have what? Muscles in them. Yes or no? Blood vessels do have muscles in them. Agree, dear?
Yes, sir.
What happens if calcium ion will rush in, muscle is going to contract. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That will lead to contraction of muscle. And because of that, what will happen? Due to contraction of muscle, what will happen? The lumen will decrease in size, and blood flow to the kidney will decrease, hence GFR will decrease. Yes or no? Means you do not see this as a functional aspect, rather than you see this as protective aspect. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Ideally what should happen? If BP is increasing, GFR should increase, na? By simple logic. If blood pressure is increasing, the GFR should increase by simple logic. But what is there? If the increased BP will be transmitted as it is, in that case, what will happen?
So damage to the vessels.
Yes. So that because of that, blood vessel is going to constrict, and that will lead to decrease in GFR. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you can write it down. Done?
Yes, sir.
Myogenic autoregulation. You people can see over here. Now, what is micturition? It is the process of release of urine. Process of release of urine. Agreed here? What happens? It is a neural mechanism. Let's see. Which kind of epithelium is present inside the urinary bladder? It is transitional epithelium. Yes or no? And outside it is peritoneum. What? Outside it is peritoneum. In between that is detrusor muscle. Yes or no? In between that is a detrusor muscle. Yes or no? Agreed, dear? What is the name of muscle that is present inside urinary bladder?
So detrusor muscle.
Detrusor muscle. In that you can see stretch receptors are there. What? When urine will fill, the bladder will expand. Yes or no? When the urine will be filled, the bladder will expand. And from here, a stretch receptor will be activated. And from here, what will happen? Nerve impulse will go to CNS. And from CNS, motor signal will come. One to detrusor muscle lead to contraction of detrusor muscle, and one to a sphincter lead to relaxation of a sphincter will lead to urination. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? You all can see. Read this one.
So what's the name of this topic?
Micturition. Process of release of urine is micturition.
So could you scroll down?
One question is also there. You people can solve. Solve the question as well. You all can apply simple logic to the question and it will be solved. Done, everyone? Do you people agree? Yes. Do you people agree with this sequence? Compare this sequence to this diagram. You will get to know what is happening actually.
Sir?
Yes.
Could you show the question again, please?
Yes.
What are the types of urethra you've written on the picture?
Prostatic urethra, membranous urethra, and penile urethra. See, this is prostate gland. This area is known as prostatic. This is membranous. And the urethra present inside the penis is penile urethra. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oh, excuse me, sir, about that question. So if the receptors are removed, would that cause incontinence, or is the incontinence due to something else?
If receptor will be removed, no, in that case, what will happen? Signal will not go to CNS. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
In that case, the motor signal for contraction of detrusor muscle and relaxation of sphincter muscle will not be there. In that case, urination will not take place. Agreed? Yes or no?
But sir, when the bladder reaches capacity, what happens?
In that case, in some of the cases, sphincter may fail. In that case, micturition will be there. Otherwise, we are going to put a catheter. Pain will be there. We are going to put a catheter in that case. And through that only, we will take out the urine.
Yes.
Yes, everyone? Now, role of other organs in excretion. It is lungs, it is liver, it is skin. Remove CO2 at 200 ml per minute. CO2 will be removed, all the volatile substances will be removed, and some of the water will be removed, especially in dry and cold climate. Okay, more in cold and dry climate, and less in hot and humid climate. Can you correlate? Can you correlate?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Liver is the largest gland of the body. It helps site of elimination of cholesterol, bile pigment, degraded esteroid, hormones, toxins, etc. Skin having cooling effect of sweat gland or sudorific gland, NaCl, urea, lactic acid, amino acid, glucose, etc. And in sebaceous gland, sterols, hydrocarbons, wax, etc. through sebum. This is from the NCRT only, and you people need to remember them because they are important as far as NEET is concerned. Especially that carbon dioxide part. This one. And composition of sweat is also important. Disorders of excretory system. What all disorders are there? One is glomerulonephritis. Second is renal failure. What is glomerulonephritis? It is the inflammation of glomerulus. Yes or no? In that case, let's see, inflammation will be there. In that case, size of size of fenestra will increase. What? Size of fenestra, this fenestra is there. It will increase. Normally protein do not cross this membrane. But once inflammation will be there, in that case, what will happen? Protein will pass. And protein will come into urine. That is known as what? That is known as what? Proteinuria due to glomerulonephritis. Proteinuria is one of the early signs of kidney failure, yes or no? If that is happening and will not be treated, it will lead to hematuria. It is appearance of blood in urine. It is similar region. The size of slit pore and fenestra will increase. Yes or no? Fenestra, you people have understood, na? The space between the endothelial cells. If it will increase more, it will let the protein go through it and the RBCs go through it. In that case, what will happen? Blood will be there in the urine and here protein will be there in the urine. Yes or no? Understood this thing?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
How does this glomerulonephritis lead to increase in the size of fenestra?
See, inflammation is going to do that only. Inflammation is going to increase the permeability of blood vessels. Inflammation is going to increase the permeability of blood vessels. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Here, proteinuria is there, hematuria is there. Now, renal failure. Renal failure is a condition when kidney stops functioning. Kidney is not functioning. In that case, what will happen? What is the function of kidney? To filter out urea from the blood.
Blood.
Yes or no? If kidney, let's see, solve this question. Kidney failure leads to increased urea in the blood, urea concentration in the blood. That condition is known as uremia. Yes or no? In case liver will be failed, ammonia will increase in the blood because ammonia is converted into urea in liver only. Yes or no? Ornithine cycle. Agreed here? How you are going to treat the renal failure? First is yes.
Could we just copy it down?
Yes.
So actually, I couldn't copy the previous one also. So could we copy both of them before moving on?
Yes.
Sir, could you go to the disorders part?
So could you show the skin again, please? Done, sir.
If hematuria will take place, now once it will be damaged, it will come almost in all the urination. It will be there. It will come.
So can glomerulonephritis be cured if by medication?
Yes. See, usually these things are there, na? Doctor will try to find out the reason. If reason will be removed, healing will be there, and some medicines are also there. Okay. It can be checked. At least progression can be checked. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Done, everyone. Let's see what happens in hemodialysis. What you are going to do in hemodialysis? You are going to take out the blood from a convenient artery. Why artery? Because you need not to regulate the flow. Artery will push the blood on its own. What is the most common complication that is going to happen if you will take out the blood from the artery? It can coagulate. It can coagulate. To prevent that coagulation, what we need to add? Heparin.
Anticoagulants.
That is added so that it should not clot. Now this is passed through a dialyzing unit, hemodialyzing unit. See, it contains fluid. It contains fluid that is having concentration same as plasma except nitrogenous waste. Okay? Means here and here, all the electrolytes are same, except here urea is there, and in this fluid urea is not there. Yes or not? In hemodialyzing fluid, urea is not there. In that case, what will happen? urea will diffuse from this side to this side. Agreed? Agreed, dear?
Yes.
Urea will diffuse from this side and from this side to this side. No issues? Now. This had happened. Now I am going to put that blood into vein. If I am putting that blood into vein, like see, patient is already ill. Patient is going to have some problem with this. You can say if this blood will go, and if some blood vessel is damaged, in that case, what will happen? Lots of internal bleeding will be there. So to check that internal bleeding, what should happen? Antiheparin is added before the blood is put into the vein. Yes or no? And this membrane is semi-permeable membrane, that is cellophane membrane. Agreed? Nothing else. So this is the concept of hemodialyzing unit or hemodialysis. Actually, this is a much more complex unit than I have shown that you can see over here. Now, is the hemodialysis is the complete cure? No, not at all. It is a palliative care only. It is only going to relax the patient for some time. The ultimate treatment is renal failure is kidney transplant. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone can write it down.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So how do they avoid air bubbles in the blood while it's going through the hemodialyzing unit?
See, for that, blood is being taken directly from the, blood only, no?
Yes, sir, but it's artery mechanical. Only, no? Yes, sir, but it's mechanical, so there's always room for error.
See, it is there, you are right, but usually it do not happen. Okay, that is taken care of. Systems are there in place. I cannot explain at this time all the systems that are there in the hemodialyzing unit. Later on, I will tell you if you want to know. Okay. First I'll see, then I will let you know, because the structures are very complex. The complete hemodialyzing unit, I don't know at this point of time. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. I will let you know later on.
Yeah, got it, sir.
Okay. Machine is there. I have not seen the machine from inside. I have seen the process of hemodialyzing dialysis. Connections are made. How connections are made, that I know. Done, everyone?
Just a minute, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Theoretically, we could hemodialyze a patient for their entire life, right?
Yes, but actually, lots of complications are there. You cannot do it for much longer period.
So what is the most basic complication that can happen?
Lots of things are lost. Proteins are lost and lots of things are there. And one more thing, the most basic complication is there. Like urea is removed on the daily basis, but dialysis is not done every day. So what happens? Urea keep on building in the blood. Okay, that person is not going to have much efficiency actually.
Yes, sir, got it. Done, sir.
We do not do hemodialysis on daily basis, agreed? Now, the kidney transplant is the ultimate cure for renal failure. Now, one thing is renal calculi. Renal calculi, it is the kidney stone. Deposition of heavy salts like oxaloacetic, oxalate, etc. Oxalate is a heavy salt, yes or no? If it will be there in the more concentration, it will deposit and will form a stony mass inside kidney. That is known as a renal calculi or kidney stone. Agreed? Agreed here? Now, see this pathway. Phenylalanine, tyrosine, 5-hydroxyphenyl, pyruvic acid, homogentisic acid, and malolactic acid. Agreed? Let's see over here. Phenylalanine.
What
this is a pathway. This phenylalanine is there. It is metabolized like this. Yes or no? Now see, this enzyme is there, phenylalanine hydroxylase. This enzyme is converting phenylalanine into tyrosine. Agreed?
Yes,
sir. What will happen if there is a defect in the gene of this enzyme? Phenylalanine will not be metabolized to a tyrosine. In that case, it will be building in the blood and it will come in the urine. That is known as phenylketonuria. The name of the enzyme is, correct name is hydroxylase. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? So, let's see. Homogentisic acid is also known as L-captone. If homogentisate 1,2 dioxygenate, this enzyme is having defective gene. In that case, what will happen? This will not be metabolized and will be building in the blood. That will lead to L-captonuria. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Write it down. You are going to read this in genetics also in 12th. Read everyone.
Just a minute, sir.
Done.
So just a minute, sir.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Done, everyone. Done.
So just a minute. Answer.
Now see, pyuria. Py means pus. Presence of pus in urine. In urine test, pus cell will be there. Cystitis is inflammation of urinary bladder. Now, one important thing is ornithine cycle that is there. First thing, it is there in the, it takes place in the hepatocytes, means liver cells. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
It takes place in liver cells. And in which cell organelle? Mitochondria and cytoplasm. Mitochondria and cytoplasm. Agreed? See, amino acid glutamate is there. Transamination will take place. Alpha-ketoglutaric acid will be formed and 1 NH4 will be released. Yes or no? In reductive emanation, I have told you people in mineral nutrition last page that alpha keto glutaric acid is going to combine to NH4 to form glutamate. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if glutamate will be broken, it will give these two. Now NH4, and this is CO2. With the help of enzyme carbamoyl phosphate synthase, it will form carbamoyl phosphate by using 2 ATP inside mitochondria. So can you see how many ATP are used inside mitochondria? Tell me.
Sir, 2.
Now you see, this carbamoyl phosphate is going to combine to ornithine to form citrulline. And this citrulline will combine to aspartate to form arginosuccinate. Yes or no? Arginosuccinate is releasing fumarate to form arginine. And you are going to get urea after hydrolysis of arginine. Only 3 points are important. One, how many ATP is used in mitochondria? Another, how many ATP is used in cytoplasm? Okay, and how many total ATP is used? And after hydrolysis of what? Usually we confuse that, we take ornithine. That is wrong. Ornithine is recovered after that. Arginine is going to give you urea and ornithine. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So how many ATP is used inside mitochondria? How many ATP is used outside mitochondria, that is cytoplasm? Okay, and one, what all wastes are removed in the ornithine cycle? CO2 and NH4. You need not to copy all these things. Only names are important. Okay? Just name. Nothing else.
So you will send these as notes later, right?
Yes, I will send it.
Okay, sir.
Could you show the picture again?
Yes. done. Are we done?
So what's the compound which is synthesized by arginosuccinic acid synthase?
What? Argino?
The
synthase. Arginosuccinate. See, citrulline is combining with aspartate to form arginosuccinate in the presence of enzyme arginosuccinic acid synthase. Agreed?
Yes, sir. So how many ATPs are used in each, sir?
2 ATP is used in mitochondria and 1 ATP is used in cytoplasm during conversion of citrulline into arginosuccinate. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Total 3 ATP is used. You can solve this question. These two questions. Hello. Mm-hmm. And everyone, we are done with excretory system now. The next topic is locomotion and movement. Let's see. Are you people done with muscular tissue in animal tissue? Muscle contraction or not?
In school, sir.
You people have done animal tissue before, na?
Yes, sir.
You have done all these things, contraction and all?
No, sir.
No? Let's see. Actually, we are going to discuss the locomotion and movement chapter. Agreed? In that, one part is muscle and one part is skeletal system. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Actually, muscle is the part of muscular tissue, animal tissue. It should be taught over there only. Let's see. It is contractile in nature. It is mesodermal in origin. What? It is contractile in nature. It is mesodermal in origin. Then, types of muscle tissue: skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. What all are there? Skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Agreed, dear? We will discuss different types of muscle in the subsequent, you can say, slides, leak. But over here, first we are going to start with skeletal muscle. Yes or no? It brings about movement at joint, where joint act like a fulcrum. Yes or no? Like scissor is there, na? This is the fulcrum. Likewise, joint is going to act like a fulcrum. Let's see. First, we will talk about a structure of a skeletal muscle. I have taken this cross section over here. What is the outermost layer? Epimysium. Which layer is there? Epimysium. Then, can you people see over here? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Please reply. See, in simple term, muscle fiber means a muscle cell. Muscle fiber is a muscle cell. Agreed? Muscle fiber is a muscle cell, nothing else. Now you see, what should be the outermost boundary of a cell? What should be the outermost boundary of a cell? Should it be the plasma membrane?
Yes, sir.
See, can you see deep blue structure that is there? Over here, and outside that gray one is there?
Yes, sir.
What is that deep blue structure known as? Deep blue structure is the sarcolemma. Outside sarcolemma, what is there? Endomysium. Which layer? Endomysium is there just outside the sarcolemma. Agreed, dear? Agreed? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
This come outside outer a bit. This light blue, this is known as perimysium. What? Perimysium. Agreed? This is going to form a muscle bundle. This is going to form a muscle bundle. Agreed? Perimysium. It is going to form a muscle bundle. Now you see, what is there between the muscle bundles? What is there between the muscle bundles? What is this? What is there between the muscle bundle? It is fascia. What is fascia? It is a connective tissue sheath that connects muscle bundle. Yes or no? It is a connective tissue sheath that connects muscle bundle. Agreed, dear? Everyone? Let's see. Sarcolemma is there, then endomysium is there, then perimysium is there, then fascia is there, and the outermost layer is what? Epimysium. So can you arrange the layer inside to outside and outside to inside? Can you do that?
Yes, sir.
Then you people can draw the diagram. Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Similar structure is there for nerve also. Nerve. This is the exolema. Outside it, it is endoneurium. For that, neurium word is used. Okay, endomysium, here endoneurium, then perineurium, and outermost is epineurium. Yes or no? Similar thing is used for nerve also. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
Done? Now. Yes, please draw.
Answer.
Let's see. Let's see over here. This is muscle fiber. Outside muscle fiber, sarcolemma is there. Agreed? And inside sarcolemma, sarcoplasm is there. Agreed? Inside sarcoplasm, you people can observe many parallelly arranged myofibrils. Done? Many parallelly arranged myofibrils. Many parallelly arranged myofibrils are there. No issues? Agreed? Do you people agree with this line? Please tell me. In sarcoplasm, there are many parallelly arranged myofibrils are there. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, what myofibrils are made up of myofilaments. And NCERT has told myofilament and myofibrils are same as per NCERT, but actually they are having difference in diameter. See, fibers having more diameter, fibrils having lesser, and filament having even lesser diameter. Yes or no? It is because of that only definition is there. Let's see. Myofilament is of two types. One is actin myofilament. Another is myosin myofilament. Agreed, dear? Everyone? Agreed, dear? Actin myofilament and myosin myofilament. Do you people have any doubt in this? Tell me. Say yes or no?
No, sir.
Yes. Let's see over here. Actin is made up of filamentous actin, troponin, and tropomyosin. And myosin is made up of, it is a polymer of meromyosin. Agreed? Here, actin and myosin are contractile protein, and troponin, tropomyosin are regulatory protein. Agreed, dear? Are regulatory proteins. Agreed. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Myosin, myofilament is made up of actin myofilament and myosin myofilament. Actin myofilament having filamentous actin, troponin, and tropomyosin. And myosin myofilament having meromyosin as the constituent. Yes or no? Filamentous actin and myosin are there. They are contractile protein. And troponin and tropomyosin are the regulatory protein. Agreed? No issues?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Let's see. Actin filament is there. Here, can you see circles? Are many circles are there? What are they? They are globular actin. What? They are globular actin. Agreed here?
Yes, sir.
Globular actin. And when they will combine, they will form filamentous actin. What? Filamentous actin. Agreed here? So can I say filamentous actin is a polymer of globular actin? Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? And now, this blue one. This blue one is tropomyosin. What? The tropomyosin. Agreed? And on that, you can see there are three circles over here. Gray color circle that is representing troponin. Actually, troponin is going to have three components. One is troponin I. One is troponin C. And one is troponin T. You see, actin filament is there, na? What is this? What is this?
Myosin binding site.
Myosin binding site is there, na? Okay. What do you think? What troponin I is doing? Is it masking the myosin binding site? Compare this situation and this situation, please compare.
Yes, so it is masking the binding site.
Agreed here? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, and what is the likely function of troponin C? Is it attaching itself to the calcium ion? Tell me, dear.
Yes.
What is the likely function of troponin C? Is it attaching to the calcium ion? And what is the likely function of troponin T? Is it attaching it to the tropomyosin? You see, when calcium arrives, it pulls it by combining with troponin C, leads to unmasking of myosin binding site present on actin filament. Yes or no? Tell me. Release of calcium leads to binding of calcium to the troponin C, thus unmasking the myosin binding site present on the actin filament. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? So this is troponin. Done, everyone? Can you people understand troponin, tropomyosin, and filamentous actin nicely and complete a structure of actin filament? You can draw this. Are we done?
Just a minute, sir.
Done, sir.
Done. Yes. Next is myosin filament. It is a polymer of myosin. You can see the structure of myosin. You will get to know. See, there are two protein polypeptide with black. Okay. This is long polypeptide. And there are two. This bluish one in the head. This is short polypeptide, agreed? Long polypeptide and short polypeptide, agreed? So can you see over here how many long polypeptide is there?
Sir, two.
And how many total short polypeptides are there?
Four.
So total number of polypeptide in myosin is?
Six.
It is a hexamer. This part is going to form the tail. This part is going to form the head. Head having long as well as short polypeptide. Tail having only long polypeptide. Agreed? Done? So you people need to see these things. Okay. Rest we will discuss in the next class because this will take time. Okay? And one thing. Notes of XCT system I have already sent. It is there. It is in continuation with that note only. Everything is there in that note. Yes or no? You got that note?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I am going to send this note now. Okay, dear. Bye.